The coronavirus disease, or the COVID-19 pandemic, which originated in the city of Wuhan, China, quickly spread to many countries worldwide, including India. The first case of COVID-19 in India was reported on January 30, 2020. Thereafter, two more cases were reported in February. Subsequently, more cases came to the forefront in the month of March, and there was a surge in the number of cases since the latter half of April 2020. India promptly responded to the novel threat. International borders were shut and nationwide lockdown was imposed from March 25, 2020 to control the transmission of the deadly virus. As per the Oxford COVID-19 government response tracker, India's response was rated as one of the most stringent in the world. Daily COVID positive cases that peaked in India in mid-September with over 90,000 cases reported per day eventually dropped down to below 15,000 in January 2021. India began its vaccination program on 16 January 2021, and by February 2021, daily cases had fallen to 9,000 per day. However, by early April 2021, a major second wave of infections hit the country. On 9 April 2021, India surpassed 1 million active cases, and by 12th April, India overtook Brazil as having the second most COVID-19 cases worldwide, behind only the United States. The second All India surge has been more devastating than the first, and it has also appeared to be different from the last year's surge in several ways, increasing worries and anxiety. The second wave has placed a major strain on the healthcare system, including an ongoing shortage of liquid medical oxygen due to an unanticipated high demand. Identifying the lack of oxygen concentrators as a critical equipment that India was lacking, the American Association of Physicians of Indian Origin, API, a prominent medical association led by its president, Dr. Sudhakar Jonalagadda, has raised $2.5 million so far to buy oxygen concentrators. API has sent 1,000 oxygen concentrators so far and has bought another 1,000 concentrators to be sent. In addition to this, API has tapped into their wide network of doctors to provide free consultations to patients from India over Zoom. Since API had the expertise and the knowledge of how to deal with the COVID situation, but not the manpower and resources on the ground, they partnered with a well-known non-profit organization, Seva International. Seva USA has volunteers working round the clock to figure out how to purchase the essential equipment from different countries and send it to India. Seva has already sent 2,000 oxygen concentrators to India using the funding provided by API and several others. It is providing families with medical kits and is looking at launching a 24-hour helpline to assist patients. They are also readying to send 1,000 BiPAP machines and 2,000 ventilators. Let's hear Dr. Gautam from Carmel Hospital speak about the contribution of API supported by Seva.
Namaste. I am Dr. Gautam from Carmel Hospital. We have been seeing how people in India have been getting massively infected in the second wave of COVID-19. People are struggling to find hospitals with available beds, and there is a huge oxygen shortage. To address this issue, Sri Guru Ramlalji Ashram created an isolation center in New Delhi with the help of Seva Bharati. Seva organization, in collaboration with API, have facilitated 30 beds and 6 pipeline oxygen cylinders. This has greatly helped in meeting the huge demand for oxygen. It has also helped people move to big hospitals with beds. And with the help of these oxygen concentrators, a lot of people were able to return back to their homes. We express a heartfelt gratitude to API and Seva Bharati.
And the work does not stop there. For Seva, the aim is to build capacities in India's rural areas so they can tackle any other wave effectively.